probably one of the better looking cars ever built, but.
I don't know. I've had both. Like, I've had black radius rods polished, kept the aluminum panels all aluminum.
The only thing that sucks about having polished stuff is keeping it that way.
Yeah.
Keeping it looking nice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You want to start with the floor pan then?
Looks like the floor
pan. Well, I'm guessing we got to start with the floor pan,
yeah. Sweet. Is there any particular reason you guys like to bolt your floor pan in?
I'm scared of the floor pan falling out.
Yeah.
Even when I ran the wraparound style, I would still bolt it in, even if I had to Zeus it.
Okay.
Yeah, I've always bolted mine in too. Nothing worse than having the floor pan disappear.
I think the plan is to use all titanium hardware too. So we'll have pretty much every bolt should be titanium. Even the floor pan bolts will be titanium, obviously, and all the way down to master cylinder bolts. So, and then we can go ahead and start drilling the rest of them out then.
Yep.
So with those jet nuts, are you just gonna get them snug, overly tight?
Well,
they don't need to be too tight.
They don't need to be super tight, but you want enough that the thing's not moving around.
Okay.
Don't do that. It's on the bottom.
That's
true. You see that if you're upside down. That's the worst part, the first scratch you put in the chassis, you just want to kill yourself. I just spent how much to get this powder coated and I scratched it getting it out of the truck.
I think we should get brake lines next, honestly.
Okay.
That way we can get them through there without having to try to fish it through the motor plate.
Make it a little bit easier. So we got the brake line, the AN2 brake line kit with AN3 ends on it. With the brake lines, we're just going to put them in place and zip tie them, and then we'll get to the bulkheads later once we start doing like the axles, and then we'll put the bulkheads on and hook up the brake lines.
And this is why I like to do it without having the motor plate on the car, because then you can just feed it all right through. Boy, that's a nice tie. Doesn't even click.
I think we'll do the motor plate next. All right, so we'll pop this in here, and there's a notch right here towards the bottom of the motor plate to kind of help with some brake line clearance there.
That's a pretty slick feature there.
That is pretty cool.
I used to do that myself.
Yeah.
Little grinder action. Cut them out, yeah.
You want these pretty snug. They're kind of the,
I would think it's the
central part of the car. Like
yeah.
Yeah, it's no fun if the motor falls out in the middle of the front straight.
Not winning any races at that point. So motor plate's in, brake lines are in, floor pan's in. I think what's next would probably be the dash.
Yeah.
Yeah, sweet. Yeah, the top two. We'll get the dash in, freshly waxed and polished. Holla.
It goes behind the motor plate. There we go. Yeah.
That one's tight.
Jeez, that's
that
a tight,
tight
one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There we go. It went. All right, well, I think that about does it for today. We've got a couple guys coming in next time, and they'll put in the steering gear and the wing lines, and we'll get her a little bit closer. So thanks so much for your help, and see you next time.
Thanks, Charles.
Sweet. Thank you.